Hi, and welcome to 5 Questions with Fidelity. I'm Suzie Allen, joined by Ben Isgur, Vice President, Healthcare Thought Leadership here at Fidelity. Ben, welcome.
Hi, Suzie. Glad to be here.
Ben, thank you for taking time to talk about an important topic that will affect most of today's retirees. When it comes to healthcare costs and retirement, what should people be thinking about?
Well, there's a lot to think about because health costs are often more than people think they're going to be. One of the challenges with healthcare costs is they're actually pretty unpredictable. Unlike other expenses that may be fixed or have a slight range, healthcare costs can vary by person based on their medical conditions and even where they live. According to our recent Fidelity Retiree Healthcare Cost Estimate, the average 65-year-old retiring this year can expect to need more than $157,000 to cover medical and healthcare expenses throughout retirement. For a couple, that's more than $300,000. And this estimate does not cover the cost of long-term care if that's needed. So our research reveals there's a major gap between what people will need to spend on healthcare in retirement, more than $300,000, versus what they think they will spend, according to our survey, less than $150,000 per couple. To make this a bigger challenge, the costs of healthcare typically rise faster than your average inflation year over year.
You mentioned these costs don't include long-term care. Let's define what that is and the likelihood you'll need it.
Yes, long-term care is one area that everyone should consider. It is not covered by Medicare, and we know that long-term care can be a major expense and a cause of stress. Long-term care typically refers to the non-medical care that is important for independent living. So these are what are called activities of daily living, and they include things like bathing, dressing, being able to move out of a bed or chair, eating, using the bathroom, and continence. Not being able to perform these and any type of cognitive decline may result in a loved one not being able to take care of themselves, regardless of other health needs. So for someone turning 65 today, there's almost a 70% chance of needing some type of long-term care coverage during retirement. Now, exactly what that coverage looks like can vary, but here are a couple of stats we do know. According to a study from the U.S. Department of Health and Human Services, the average use of long-term care services is 3 years. We also know that 20% of individuals will need long-term care for 5 years or longer, especially those suffering from cognitive impairments like Alzheimer's or other causes of dementia.
Let's focus on Medicare a bit. As you've mentioned, it's not comprehensive, but it is a major source of healthcare coverage for most retirees over age 65. How can someone make sure to get the most out of that coverage?
Well, to start with, I think it's important to understand the different types of Medicare. You've got Original Medicare and Medicare Advantage, so it's not a singular plan. Now, Original Medicare is made up of two parts. You have Part A, which covers the hospital costs, and Part B, which covers doctor's costs. But Original Medicare does not cover some benefits people may be used to having, like dental, vision, hearing, and even prescription drugs, which are known as Part D of Medicare. In Original Medicare, you must pay 20% of the cost of care, although you can purchase what are known as gap plans to cover some of those costs. Now, the other major option is Medicare Advantage, and it may look and feel a little bit more like an employer health plan because Medicare Advantage typically has a provider network, a drug plan included, and can even have dental, vision, and hearing included as well. There are differences between these types of plans that may be important to you depending on where you live or where you want to live, what you're used to, and the costs associated with them. Bottom line, it's important to review and understand the multitude of options available for the level of coverage that an individual prefers.
Lots to consider. So what about people who leave the workforce before age 65? What are some strategies to bridge the coverage gap until Medicare kicks in?
Well, options for healthcare coverage before you turn 65 can include a lot of different things, and these include your spouse's employer's health plan, if they're still working, the Affordable Care Act, or what's known as marketplace coverage, or even staying on COBRA coverage with your own job after you leave, or a combination of any of these options. There's no single right answer, so it's wise to explore all the options available to you before deciding to see which choice meets your health needs and budgets. Once you are eligible for Medicare, however, sign up right away to avoid late enrollment penalties.
Those are great points. What are some other strategies that can help retirees manage their healthcare costs?
One strategy to manage retiree health costs is the health savings account. These accounts are triple tax advantaged, meaning you contribute pre-tax dollars, you pay no taxes on earnings, and withdraw the money tax-free now or in retirement to pay for qualified medical expenses. HSA money can be used to pay for current health costs, but it can also be saved or built up over time for future health costs. The tax treatment of an HSA provides the potential for strong financial growth. So if you can cover healthcare expenses out of your current cash flow, you may want to consider paying for those out-of-pocket costs and then putting the rest of the money in your HSA to help fortify your retirement. It's never too early to start planning for long-term care coverage. The younger you are, typically the less it is going to cost to have that coverage. So obtaining long-term care insurance can be key. You can also keep the health cost gap in mind that I started with and make sure extra savings are included for either health costs, long-term care, or a combination of needs. Lastly, there are many non-financial issues associated with health and retirement, such as mental health, loneliness, and preparing for a new life in retirement. Getting the basics done around preparing, saving, and using different tools to prepare can reduce anxiety and make the jump into retirement a soft landing.
Wow, that's a lot to plan for. It sounds like people may want to consider working with a financial professional who can help you assess the reality of healthcare costs and determine the most efficient way to save for them.
That's something I would strongly recommend.
Well, Ben, thank you so much for joining me today.
It's been a pleasure.
For more timely news and thinking from Fidelity's top thought leaders, subscribe to Insights from Fidelity Wealth Management. I'm Suzie Allen. Talk to you soon.